Hey, back inside the treasure chest. Late night in the treasure chest, weeknight besides, and we're back out packing orders, getting ready to ship for tomorrow morning. We had a busy night tonight, out and about, and now we're finally getting around to packing orders. 13 orders going out, so that's a lot for us on a weeknight. Q4 is definitely hitting us, so that's a good thing. We're not complaining. First thing sold, actually, it came in as we were pulling orders, so we just pulled it. It's a golf head cover, Callaway Big Bertha, and that's out the door for $14.90 plus shipping, and bought that for about 50 cents. Goodwill bins?
Garage sale.
Garage sale, okay. Next thing that sold is a Nike hat, ladies hat, and that went for $12 plus shipping, and that was found at the bins for 50 cents. Next thing is a bunch of Archie comics. This is the second lot we've sold. They're actually Janelle's, so they were personal use, I guess free. They weren't free, but she got her use out of them. She's trying to unload some of her Archie comics. She used to collect them quite a bit. That lot went for $21, and it's a lot of 14. Now, you're not going to be able to see this one. Janelle already bubble wrapped it up, but it's a Imaginext SpongeBob SquarePants Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy figures. They're figurines. And that's out the door for $29.90 plus shipping. So that's pretty cool. Drop that into probably a PFRE or one of the small flat rate boxes and out the door that goes. Next thing sold was a sticker maker. And we've had that since October. Out the door for $20. And we got $3 into that. And the SpongeBob SquarePants figurines is part of a $10 lot of figures that we bought. So. And now a couple of Halloween costumes that we sold. We've been selling a lot of Halloween costumes. We've had a lot of Halloween costumes. We found some at garage sales. I think Janelle found some at the bins, right? And, they obviously didn't sell all summer, but we stocked up on them. That's why, I guess, if I were to put a tip into this video, that's the tip of this video, is try to stock up on items, seasonal items, throughout the whole year. Golf clubs, baseball gloves, Halloween costumes, and that'll try to steady out your sales a little bit throughout the year, because maybe you're saying, oh, darn, I'm not selling anything all summer long, Well, maybe you got all winter stuff listed. Try to find some baseball gloves, and get them all stocked up, even though they're not selling in the winter. Just keep buying them as you find them, and they will thin out as the season comes. So it's kind of like our Halloween costumes. All right, back to the sale. Halloween costume, police officer, kids Halloween costume, sold for $15. I actually got all Halloween costumes on sale right now. I don't want to hang on to them for the next year because I'm sure we're going to find more. So I'd like to get them all unloaded in another rotation and make our money on them. Another Halloween costume, a ghostly spirit. And this is adult costume. Adult costumes seem to sell better for us and for a little more money. That one's out the door for $22.39 plus shipping. And then you've probably seen this next item on a video. If you didn't see it, then you need to go back and watch that video. It is the Scooby-Doo salt and pepper shakers. We got footage of us picking them up at a flea market, was it?
It was a community garage.
There's a community garage. They all roll into each other.
Yeah.
And that's out the door for $15, and we got $5 into that. So after fees and that, maybe about $6, $7 profit, which is okay. Something easy to ship, sells fast.
It could have gone for $35 if it was in better shape. I thought they were new when I first bought them. I opened them up when I got them home, and one of the sides, the paint was peeling off. I mean, the salt and pepper shakers themselves were in good shape as far as no cracks or anything like that. They looked unused, but I don't know if wherever they were stored, the paint was coming off on the one side. So took a hit on that a little bit.
And sold a Blue's Clues interactive talking computer. That's out the door for $19.94 plus shipping. Janelle's got a dollar on it. It was probably less than a dollar. It was found at the bins, so it's by weight. Now it's time for some plush. Sold a Carter's Orange Tiger plush. That's out the door for $24.99 for that little guy, plus shipping, and She's saying she's probably got about 20 cents into that. It's also from the bins.
At the bins, the hard goods, housewares, toys, anything that's not clothes, DVDs, books, media, is 39 cents a pound at our bins. So something like that doesn't even weigh a pound, so it's not even 39 cents. So it's about a quarter for that little plush.
Biggest challenge is having the room to store it and sit on it for a while you wait for... I mean, I think this wasn't too old. Oh, yep, July. So we've had it for a few months. So, yeah, like I said, the biggest, you know, challenge is just having enough room to store that inventory for as long as it takes to flip it. I mean, obviously, you got to get enough inventory stored up so you're getting a steady flow of sales. I mean, we're not going to buy, you know, one bin of plush and sit on it and wait for it to sell. You know, it's her full-time income. We want a steady flow of money coming in throughout the year. So.
And I definitely take that into account when I'm looking at things, the size of it, because if it's not worth enough for the size of it, you know, I got to store it. I got to find a spot for it. So that...
I mean, this will probably go first-class shipping, dropping our 6x6 box, which I still haven't done a video on our shipping yet, but show them how we do a shipping.
We'll
owe you guys that video. We'll get it out. But with Q4 and that, we're kind of buried right now, but... Yeah, dropping
yeah,
in a box.
Yeah, something like that. That doesn't take up any space.
Next thing, pretty interesting. I think garage sale item, right?
Estate sale.
Estate sale. Yes, I remember the estate sale. We may have footage. I don't think... You might have done a talk on it, I think.
Maybe. Yes,
but
I think I did.
She got a bunch of these keychains from estate sale. So, what are they, 50 cents each?
50 cents each.
And we finally sold one of them. I mean, they're small enough. She got them cheap enough. We could store them somewhere in a little bin and sit on them for 2 years. Who cares? But that one went out for $7 plus shipping. Sold a remote. Janelle likes finding remotes. You find them all over the place. How many times are people losing the remotes? Hey, where do I go to find this remote for this? You know, I don't want to buy a whole new unit. Go on eBay, search for it. 20 cents from the bins. She's got out the door for $15 plus shipping.
I look up a lot of remotes that aren't worth anything, but I always look them up. Always check the remotes. You never know.
And the most fun thing I think we sold from this batch. Sorry, I got to look at my list here because I don't know anything about plush. You know what? Why don't I let Janelle tell you about this plush because she is the plush queen.
So I bought this for $5 at a little thrift shop, not a Goodwill or anything, just a locally owned thrift shop. What do you call it? Consignment. Got it for $5, and it's a Cloud B lamb. It's got the little tag on around
Cloud,
the neck.
Cloud cell. B scent you look for?
Cloud, I always look at the baby plush, baby, you know, themed ones. I don't know. I mean.
What do you mean by baby? Is it sea baby in it? Or is it just baby themed?
It's the theme, I think.
Oh, okay.
Just,
anything for
sorry.
A baby.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, just like the Carter's plush. A lot of those aren't always worth it, but just I always check them because you never know. So this, and because of the size, I think there's some different sizes that aren't worth as much, but what did this sell for?
$62 out the door, plus shipping.
So bought it for $5.
And that's domestic shipping, so I'll stuff it in a 13x13x9 box.
It won't hurt it at all.
Priority box and out the door. So that's it for tonight. I'm going to get this stuff packed up. I didn't run the numbers, so I don't know how much we made in sales today, but I'll throw it on the screen for you, so I'll, you know, show you what it is. I don't want to just show you the gross sales and how much, you know, because we got fees and shipping expenses and everything else tied into it, so I'll show you what we made for just today, and we'll see you on the next video.